There are a lot of new exciting conversations happening about character. One that I find interesting is that there are 7 strengths in particular that can be real game changers in academic achievement, success, and happiness, no matter what your circumstances. Those 7 are optimism, gratitude, social intelligence, curiosity, self-control, enthusiasm, and perseverance, also known as grit. While there have been many different theories about character throughout history, what scientists in this field agree on is that character matters, and that character strengths can be learned, practiced, and cultivated. So when you think about yourself, what are your strengths? And how can you find ways to use them more in your home, work, school, and community? It's like you have these superpowers, and focusing your attention on them makes them stronger.
Yes.
And then, if you focus on the people around you and their strengths, it makes them stronger too. As each of us becomes our best versions of ourselves and encourages others to do the same, we can lead to important changes throughout the world. Just imagine a world infused with more humanity, justice, courage, wisdom, and compassion. So if you can be a better version of yourself, how do you want to be?
I definitely want to be somebody that other people can feel they can rely on.
A man who was courageous.
Somebody who went for their goals.
A risk taker.
Kind.
Exactly like my mom. Beautiful, strong, and powerful.
I want people to say that I'm funny.
Who is the nice person?
Música.
Generous.
Be yourself.
Kind.
Accountable.
Incondicional.
I'm an child of mercy.
También sensible. Profesional.
Charismatic.
I want to become someone who, when the time comes for me to die, I go, oh my goodness, I have used it up. I have wrung it dry.
Yeah. Everybody is a star. They just need to learn how to shine.
How cool is that? Ah, I just get so inspired. I know it's so cheesy, but I get so inspired by that. Yeah. So there was a lot in there. And the idea is that you can find out what your top 5 strengths are. So these are the things, the 5 virtues that you already have in spades. The ones that come easiest for you. And then what you do is actually really simple. You just ask yourself, how can I use those strengths more often in all areas of my life? And then when adversity strikes and you need to be more resilient, you just ask yourself a slight change to that question. You know, how can my top 5 character strengths, how can I use them to get through this, to overcome this, to thrive after this? It's just a question. You gotta know what they are, and then you gotta ask yourself, how do I use them? And then you follow through on those ideas. And here is the thing that's so, why this is such a pleasurable thing to do, is imagine that. Yeah, okay, let's do this. Imagine that something really bad is happening, right? Like you've got like a conflict with somebody at work, okay? And you're really, like, your communication skills are not that great. So you're focused on how you just don't communicate well, and you really just don't see your way through this conflict, right? Like you don't see yourself making it any better. So you show up to the meeting and it doesn't go well. Like you don't communicate what you need to communicate, and you walk away and you go, yeah, I'm really not good at communicating. That sucked. And my life is a little bit worse now. Versus, okay, I've got this meeting with somebody that I'm having a conflict with, and gosh, you know, like my communication in the past really hasn't been that great. I don't think that's going to see me through this. What else can I do? You go, okay, well, how can I use my five character strengths so that I can be successful, that I can increase the likelihood that I'm successful at this meeting? You're like, well, I'm really fucking funny. So how can I use my humor? How can I use my humor to make this conflict not so tough, to like loosen it up? And you go into the meeting with an idea of how specifically to use your character strengths in that meeting. Chances are you're going to be, your likelihood of being successful, of having a positive outcome from that meeting, is so much higher, right? And that builds your resiliency, because when you approach life from your strengths instead of your weaknesses, you're going to meet with success more and more often. And each time you step out and you're willing to do that, hi, Solar Radiant. It's like I just knew you were there because I was in the middle of talking and I couldn't see anything happen, but I just knew it. Hi, welcome. I love it too. So when you begin to show up in life from your strengths and you're willing to take that step to apply them and get creative with how you apply them, and that first step meets back with a success, you're going to be a little bit more confident to do it again. And then that one meets with success. And then you're going to be a little bit more confident to do it again and again and again and again. And it becomes this like virtuous cycle of success where you're building all this confidence on your way to a life that you really want to have. And as the adversity strikes, and we know it is going to strike, and you bring your character strengths to bear and you apply them and you get over the adversity with a little bit more ease, a little bit more success, and you do that over and over and over again, man, you're going to be building confidence and a belief in yourself that you can handle anything. And that belief in yourself is what really resilient people have and what they believe about themselves. So this is a way of building your resilience, building your, like, your practical resilience, right? Like, I'm in the moment and I need to solve this problem. This is a way to build it, because now you can apply your character strengths to it. And it's also a way to build like your long-term resiliency bank, because you're starting to believe in yourself that you can handle anything. And just imagine what like your life would be like if you didn't have to worry about the unknowns, because you can handle them. I mean, like, I get a little bit emotional about it, because that feels really fucking freeing to me. And I bet it feels pretty freeing to you. And this research is saying that it's possible, you guys. So it's just so, so, so cute. Hi there, threes and twos, welcome. Yeah, so like this stuff is, like, it is sweet. It's super powerful, and it feels good to apply it. So like who wouldn't want to do that? Yeah, and like the video we just watched mentioned, is that when you can start recognizing character strengths in the people that are closest to you, or when they can tell you what their character strengths are, and you start like celebrating those in them and reinforcing those in them, you're building up their superpowers. And they're going to feel really fucking good about it. And your relationship is going to get better. When you have conflict in a relationship and you can approach it from your character strengths, and if you then can recognize what their character strengths are and approach the problem solving around that, your relationships are going to be so much better. They're going to get richer and stronger. And as we know, when the shit hits the fan and you need help to be resilient, right? Like we need support. We need close relationships. Those relationships are going to be stronger and they're going to be more supportive. And they're going to know that, like, oh, these are your strengths. Like, let's come on. You know you've got these strengths. You can handle this. You can handle anything. It's really cool. So, yeah, it is so, so freeing. So I'm going to show you now this. And this is the 24 character strengths. Okay, there we go. So the 24 character strengths have been broken down into six categories. And again, this was done so that psychologists could use science to measure them and figure out, how can we increase them in our lives? Can we increase them in our lives? And yes, we can, which is just mind-blowing. So yeah, like, the first category is the virtue of wisdom, and that's creativity, curiosity, judgment. Judgment, right? Like, critical thinking, love of learning, and perspective taking, or perspective. Then you've got the virtue of courage, which I just gotta say is, like, the part that I get the most excited about, which is probably why I'm in love with resiliency, because it requires a lot of courage. But bravery, perseverance, honesty, which is about being your authentic self and sharing that, and zest. The virtue of humanity is love, kindness, social intelligence, virtue of justice, teamwork, fairness, leadership, virtue of temperance, forgiveness, humility, prudence, self-regulation, and the virtue of transcendence. This is like the spiritual realm, so to speak. Appreciation of beauty and excellence, gratitude, hope, humor. I love that humor's in there, because I think it is spiritual, right? Like, it does help us transcend life. And spirituality, which is just connecting with the sacred and with what's meaningful and purposeful in your life. It also includes religion for people who are religious. So those are it. Like, you guys, these are across human history, across all cultures, these are the 24 like traits or virtues that everybody agrees on is a good thing to do or to have. And we have all of them to varying degrees. So, I'm gonna sing while I'm figuring out what I'm doing. I can't believe I just did that. Okay. So there are two places to test your character strengths. And I'm going to show you that, because guess what? You can find out what they are for free, because these positive psychologists are they're just really good people, and they really want this stuff to get out there, because it really is something that just makes your life that much more awesome. So this is the VIA Institute on Character. It stands for, Virtues in Action. Yeah, I remembered it. Okay. So yeah, this is the VIA Institute on Character, and you can take it here, the survey, for free to figure out what your top five are. You can also access them at University of Pennsylvania's site, Authentic Happiness. You can just search Authentic Happiness in Google, and it will take you here. I prefer this simply because they've got a whole lot of other awesome free questionnaires, and we're going to be visiting this in future streams, because there's a lot of really, really good things here for resiliency and just learning how to live fearlessly, right? So, I'm really tempted to go ahead and take the test in front of you guys and let you guys see what it's like. And, it may take a little while. So this is a question to you guys on chat. Do you want me to do the long version, which I think may take like up to a half hour, or do you want me to do the brief strengths test, which will be much shorter? So I'm going to wait while you guys have a chance to think about that and chime in. I know what my strengths are, and they do. Like, it's interesting. Like, they do, when you take the test repeatedly, there are slight changes in your strengths because, you know, like, you end up building certain strengths, or, you know, I just happen to be building my strength and humor because I am taking an improv class or something, right? And all of a sudden it like is climbing up the chart. So things like that are natural and that will happen. That's cool, right? This is just a snapshot at where you are now and what are your strengths now and how can you bring them to bear. And chances are these are strengths that like came naturally to you as a kid, And because you were meeting with success doing them, you just kept doing it. And like that video said, like, you were building this superpower. The more you use them, the better you get at using them, the more success you get. It's this really awesome virtual cycle. All right, I've got Soul Art Radiant saying to go for it. So I'm going to go for it. All right, so BIA survey of character strengths. Now, the real challenge here is, how do I make this entertaining? All right, so it says, please choose one option in response to each statement. All of the questions reflect statements that many people would find desirable, but we want you to answer only in terms of whether the statement describes what you are like. Be honest and accurate. Don't lie, people. We cannot rank your strengths until you answer all 240 questions. Okay, so hey, Voithought, welcome. We are exploring character strengths. It's right out of positive psychology and really quick and dirty. These are things that you can find out for free what your top five are. They're universally valued virtues across all cultures. When you find out what your five are, you then ask yourself, how can you apply them to your life? And then you start applying them and you end up meeting with more and more success, because again, these are your strengths. You're more likely to be successful doing so. And you just get this like wonderful like uphill climb of success that increases your well-being and it increases your resiliency. So I'm about to embark on a very tough thing here. I am going to take the test in front of you guys and I'm going to try to make a character strength survey entertaining as best as I can. So the thing is I'm not supposed to lie. I know what my responses, like my five strengths are. So I may just, you know, fuck with the survey and have fun. I recommend that you guys, you know, obviously follow it and be as honest and accurate as you can be. So I find the world a very interesting place. Yeah, that is very much like me. I always go out of my way to attend educational events. I mean, I'm not really around educational events, so I'm going to say neutral. I always identify the reasons for my actions. Yeah. Being able to come up with new and different ideas is one of my strong points. Yeah. See, I'm doubting it, but we're going to go with it. When I take these, no, I haven't heard of spiral dynamics. I'm going to have to look that up. Yeah, tell me more, avoid that. That sounds really, really cool. I'm guessing maybe it has to do with this like cycle of success, because sometimes I've seen it modeled as a spiral, but so when I do tests like this, sometimes I just have to go with my gut so that my head can't override and I start lying to myself. Very aware of my surroundings. I'm gonna go with neutral there. I always have a broad outlook on what is going on. I have to work for that, so I'm going to say unlike me. I have taken frequent stands in the face of strong opposition. Yeah, that's very much like me. I never quit a task before it's done. That's like me. I always keep my promises. That is like me. I'm never too busy to help a friend. A really good friend. Can I say that? Okay, cool. Oh, cool. Yeah, I'm gonna look into it. Thank you, Voithought. I love to learn, and that's just gold to me. And yeah, Solar Radiant, it is kind of like Strengths Finder. And I've done both, and I'm not like as up to date on Strengths Finder, but what I can say is that this character strengths is coming out of positive psychology, so it's directly tied to your well-being in life and your ability to flourish in life, to get into those really positive numbers in life versus like the negative where you're experiencing mental health issues. Whereas I think Strengths Finder is a little bit more specific to finding like success in the traditional sense. So it's more focused with getting what you want instead of an overall picture of being resilient and having a really high well-being. I hope that helps. Okay. So I'm always willing to take risks to establish a relationship. Yeah, that's like me. I never miss group meetings or team practices. When I have groups to hang out with, I'm all over that. I'm obviously streaming from my house right now, so I'm a little isolated. I always admit when I'm wrong. Yeah, I mean, here's the thing. This is tricky because I don't always know I'm wrong when I'm wrong. Yeah, yeti dude, let's see. Yeah, okay, so yeah, it is. It is. Like, that is a really good point. So there is a feedback loop, right, where you decide something, then you implement it, and then you get that feedback, and you make a new choice, and you apply it, and onward and onward, and then eventually it's working better and better for you. That would be a great thing to apply to how you're using your character strength. So if you are going to go into, like, a tense conversation, and you're going to use your character strength of humor to make the conflict a little bit more bearable and get through it for everybody, you're going to take feedback from how that went. And you're going to come up with an idea of maybe how to improve it next time, improve your use of humor, and then you just apply it. Yeah, that's, you guys are so smart. Yay, I'm having fun. All right, in a group, I try to make sure everyone feels included. Yes, I'm going to change that to very much like me. I have no trouble eating healthy foods. That is now very much like me, you guys. Speaking of which, this apple. How beautiful is it, first of all? It's red, with a little bit of green. It smells really good. This apple came from my fruit tree. I have, like, I don't know, 18 fruit trees that, are just pretty much now starting to bear fruit. And this is my first apple, and I wanted to show you today, and that just, I was able to fit that in kind of without looking like I'm so crazy. I never deliberately hurt anyone. Yeah, you can probably tell that's very much like me. It's important to me that I live in a world of beauty. I'm gonna say that's unlike me. I always express my thanks to people who care about me. Oh yeah. I always look on the bright side. What do you, yes. I'm a spiritual person. I have a hard time with this because I'm an atheist, but I find, so I, you know, like, spirituality is just, I guess since they're not saying I'm a religious person, I can say this is very much like me, because I very much am connected to a sense of purpose in life. I'm always humble about the good things that have happened to me. Yeah, I'm just going to say unlike me. Whenever my friends are in a gloomy mood, I try to tease them out of it. Yes. I want to fully participate in life, not just view from the sidelines. If there was a way to, like, make this more than very much like me, I would be clicking that. I always let bygones be bygones. That's also very much like me. Oh my gosh, we have a lot of steps. I gotta go fast. I am never bored. That's like me. I love to learn new things. Yes. I always examine both sides of an issue. Yes. When someone tells me how to do something, I automatically think of alternative ways to get the same thing done. Oh no, no. I know how to handle myself in different social situations. Yes, I'm gonna go up a little bit. Regardless of what is happening, I keep in mind what is most important. Yeah, that's something I've developed over time for resilience. I have overcome an emotional problem by facing it head on. Oh. I react like that because that is something you, like, rinse and repeat all the time when you're building your resilience, and, like, it's tough work. I won't lie. I will not lie to you about that. It's tough work. It's totally worth it. But, oh, I always finish what I start. Yeah, that's like me. My friends tell me that I know how to keep things real. I'm gonna say unlike me. I really enjoy doing small favors for friends. Yes. There are people in my life who care as much about my feelings and well-being as they do about their own. Yes. I really enjoy being part of a group. I'm here streaming on Twitch, so I better click very much like me. All right. Being able to compromise is an important part of who I am. Unlike me. Because, I'm just going to keep going. As a leader, I treat everyone equally well, regardless of his or her experience. Yes. Even when candies or cookies are under my nose, I never overeat. Never! Oh, come on. Unlike me. Better safe than sorry is one of my favorite mottos. No. The goodness of other people almost brings tears to my eyes. Yes. This is a little embarrassing to do in front of you guys. I get chills when I hear about acts of generosity. Chills? Okay. No. Neutral. Take that, number 42. I can always find the positive in what seems negative to others. Yeah. I practice my religion. very much unlike me. I do not like to stand out in a crowd, unlike me. Most people would say I am fun to be with, like me. I never dread getting up in the morning, unlike me. I rarely hold a grudge, unlike me. Well, it's very much unlike me. I am always busy with something interesting. Oh, yeah. I am thrilled when I learn something new. Yes. I make decisions about, like, for example, spiral dynamics. That was thrilling. Okay. I make decisions only when I have all of the facts. Yeah, that's like me. If it's an important decision. I like to think of new ways to do things. I mean, I do, no matter what the situation I'm able to fit in. Yes. My view of the world is an excellent one. Oh, yes. I never hesitate to publicly express an unpopular opinion. Yes. I am a goal-oriented person. Yes. I believe honesty is the basis for trust. Yes. I feel like I'm saying way too much yeses here, but I don't think I'm bullshitting myself. I go out of my way to cheer up people who appear down. Yes. See? Cheer people up who appear down, that's kind of just rude to, like, force it. So I'm more sophisticated than that, I would like to believe. There are people who accept my shortcomings. Oh, yeah. I am extremely loyal. Yes. I treat all people equally, regardless of who they might be. Gosh, I try to, but I know I don't, so I'm going to do unlike me. One of my strengths is helping a group of people work well together, even when they have their differences. I don't do that enough to know. I am a highly disciplined person. I always think before I speak. I experience deep emotions when I see beautiful things. At least once a day, I'm going to say unlike me. Look at my face. I went, At least once a day, I stop and count my blessings. Yeah. And that's because of Habitica. So you know. Despite challenges, I always remain hopeful about the future. Yes. My faith never deserts me during hard times. No, because I'm not. No. I do not act as if I'm a special person. I think humility might not be one of my strengths. I welcome the opportunity to brighten someone else's day with laughter. Yeah. Oh, so that kind of brings up for me this idea, guys, that, like, when you do this and you see the 24 strengths and they're ranked and you're like, oh, fuck, like, at the bottom of this is honesty. Like, that's, you might start judging yourself for that, right? And, like, I get it. Obviously, I was just like, oh, I might not be very humble. The point isn't to take this knowledge and, like, beat yourself up about it. No, like, you can only have 5 top strengths. You can't have 24 top strengths. Like, it's not possible. Life is too short, you guys. So, and these are all skills that you can build over time. And yeah, that's why life is too short. So don't beat yourself up with this. Like, just lean into using your top 5 strengths and not focusing on how to build up your weak ones, right? That's more kind of dangerous territory. And since we're focusing on building your well-being, your flourishing, your ability to live fearlessly and to be resilient, so it's about what you're really, really strong at. That's what the purpose of this is. So don't do what I just did and, like, shit all over yourself. I never approach things half-heartedly. That is like me. I changed that. I never seek vengeance. Oh, no. Yeah. What's the point? No. Maybe that's just because nothing terrible, really terrible, has happened. I'm always curious about the world. Yes. Every day I look forward to the opportunity to learn and grow. Yes. I value my ability to think critically. I value it. I don't know how much ability I have. I pride myself on being original. No. I have the ability to make other people feel interesting. Yes. I never have steered a friend wrong by giving bad advice. I must stand up for what I believe, even if there are negative results. Yes. I finish things despite obstacles in the way. Yes. I tell the truth, even if it hurts. Yes. I love to make other people happy. Yeah. I am the most important person in someone else's life. Yes. Aren't I lucky? I work at my very best when I am a group member. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Okay. Every everyone's rights are equally important to me. Well, yes, but I don't know if I do that. I'm very good at planning group activities. Yes, I control my emotions. Yes. My friends believe that I make smart choices about what I say and do. I don't know, so I'm going to go neutral. I see beauty that other people pass by without noticing. I do. If I receive a gift, I always let the person who gave it know I appreciate it. Yeah. I have a clear picture in my mind about what I want to have happen in the future. Yes. I mean, I'm a coach. I better. My life has a strong purpose. Yeah. I never brag about my accomplishments. There's a theme here. I try to have fun in all kinds of situations. Yes. I love what I do. Oh, hell yeah. I always allow others to leave their mistakes in the past and make a fresh start. Yes. I am excited by many different activities. Mm-hmm. I am a true lifelong learner. Mm-hmm. My friends value my objectivity. I don't know. Again, I don't know. I'm always coming up with new ways to do things. No. I always know what makes someone tick. Yes. People describe me as a wise beyond my years. More so when I was a kid. So I'm just going to say like me. I haven't heard that for a while. I call, maybe because I'm getting older. Oh. I've caught up with my years. I call for action while others talk. Yes. I am a hard worker. I'm going to say unlike me. My promises can be trusted. Mm-hmm. I have voluntarily helped a neighbor in the last month. No, it was the month before. My family and close friends cannot do anything that would make me stop loving them. Yeah, I never bad-mouth my group to outsiders. Oh, ouch. Never bad-mouth. I'm thinking, guys, have I done this? Lately or within my memory? I'm going to say like me because I can't remember anything. Maybe I've just blocked it out of my consciousness because I want to believe I'm a really good person. I give everyone a chance, yes. To be an effective leader, I treat everyone the same. Again, I'm not doing a whole lot of leading. I never want things that are bad for me in the long run, even if they make me feel good in the short run. No. No. I mean, let's get uncomfortable, folks. I always avoid activities that are physically dangerous. Ha! I wish I was safer. I am not. I've often been left speechless by the beauty depicted in a movie. No. I'm an extremely grateful person. Yes. If I get a bad grade or evaluation, I focus on the next opportunity and plan to do better. Yes, this goes back to what we were talking about with that cycle. The feedback loop. Yeah. In the last approximate 24 hours, I spent 30 minutes in prayer, meditation, or... Hell, yes, I have. Thank you, Habitica. I am proud that I am an ordinary person. Oh, wow. No. No. I try to add some humor to whatever I do. I would say, no, I don't try. It either is there or isn't. I look forward to each new day. This is hard because I've been so uncomfortable lately because I'm stepping outside my comfort zone so much that it's not like I'm looking forward to it. So I'm saying like me. I believe it is best to forgive and forget. No, not forget, just forgive and learn and grow. All right, guys, we're barreling through. I have many interests. Yes. Yes. I always go out of my way to visit museums. No. When the topic calls for it, I can be a highly rational thinker. I'm going to say like me, like if I really apply myself. Yes, of course. My friends say that I have lots of new and different ideas. Yes. I always get along well with people I've just met. I'm always able to look at things and see the big picture when I apply myself. I always stand up for my beliefs. Always? No. I do not give up. I am true to my own values. Oh, yes. That's values are huge in coaching. I always call my friends when they are sick. Always? No. Oh, no. Oh, I'm sorry, my friends. I always feel the presence of love in my life very much. It is important for me to maintain harmony within my group. Yeah, it I'm getting less with that, but I am like that. I am strongly committed to principles of justice and equality. No, I'm not committed. I'm not doing anything about the injustice I see. I believe that our human nature brings us together to work for common goals. Yeah, I can always stay on a diet. Always stay on a diet. I have a diet, but I think of it in terms of a lifestyle, so I don't know how to answer this. I'm gonna say like me, because I think that's how someone would view what I do. I think through the consequences every time before I act. No. If I did that, I probably never would have started streaming. I am always aware of the natural beauty in the environment. Not always. I go to extremes to acknowledge people who are good to me. Yeah. I have a plan for what I want to be doing 5 years from now. That is like me. My faith makes me who I am. No. I prefer to let other people talk about themselves. Yeah, I do. I never allow a gloomy situation to take away my sense of humor. That is true. I use humor, black humor, when things go terribly wrong. I have lots of energy. I am always willing to give someone a chance to make amends. Yep. Dun, 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 dun. I can find something of interest in any situation. No, not in any. I read all of the time. Yes. Thinking things through is part of who I am. No. I am an original thinker. I want to say very much like me. I'm going to go there because I am a good at sensing what other people are feeling. Yes. I have a mature view on life. I think so. I always face my fears. Yeah, you know, I'm going to do like me because the always part. If I'm being really honest, it's not always. And that's totally normal when you're working on living fearlessly that you don't face every single fear all the time. We're human. I never get sidetracked when I work. No. I take pride in not exaggerating who or what I am. I don't take pride. I am as excited about the good fortune of others as I am about my own. I can express love to someone else. Yes. Without exception, I support my teammates or fellow group members. Like me. All right. I refuse to take credit for work I have not done. Oh, yeah. Oh, that's awful. So, my judgment coming out. My friends always tell me I am a strong but fair leader. What kind of friends sit there and go, hi, Catherine, you are, you know, you're really strong, but you're fair at leading. I'm going to go neutral on that one. I can always say enough is enough. I can say it. I don't always follow through on it. But I think someone would think that I do that well. So I always keep straight right from wrong. Yeah. I greatly appreciate all forms of art. No. I feel thankful for what I received in life. I know that I will succeed with the goals I set for myself. I believe that each person has a purpose in life. Yes. I rarely call attention to myself. No, I'm streaming. Hello. I have a great sense of humor. I like my sense of humor. You guys can be your own judge on that one. I cannot wait to get started on a project. Yes. I rarely try to get even. Yeah, no, I never. It is very easy for me to entertain myself. If I want to know something, I immediately go to the library or the internet and look it up. Yes. Library? No. Internet? Yes. I always weigh the pros and cons. No. Really big decision, though? Yeah, I do. My imagination stretches beyond that of my friends. No, because my friends are awesome and imaginative. I am aware of my own feelings and motives. Yes. Others come to me for advice. Yes. I have overcome pain and... Yes. I stick with whatever I decide to do. Yes. I would rather die than be phony. No. No. Dying's the worst. I don't want to die. I enjoy being kind to others. Yeah. I can accept love from others. Even if I disagree with them, I always respect the leaders of my group. Yeah. Even if I do not like someone, I treat him or her fairly. Oh, I try. As a leader, I try to make all group members happy. I'm not... Oh, man. Without exception, I do my task at work or school or home by the time they are due. Without exception. Actually, yeah. I may be a crunch, but I get it done. I'm a very careful person. No. I am in awe of simple things in life that others might take for granted. Yes. When I look at my life, I find many things to be grateful for. Yes. I'm confident that my way of doing things will work out for the best. Yes. I believe in a universal power or God. No. I have been told that modesty is one of my most notable characteristics. I don't think I've ever heard that. I don't think I'm cocky, but I've never... Again, like, Catherine, your modesty is very notable. Why, thank you, masterpiece theater guy. I find satisfaction in making others smile or laugh. Yes. I can hardly wait to see what life has in store for me in the weeks or years ahead. Yeah. I am usually willing to give someone another chance. Yes. I think my life is extreme. Oh, we have other... Hi, Mommy Cupcakes. Oh, yeah, I'm sorry about your screen. That's happened to me before, too. I'll do my best to speak well, so at least you get that. All right. I think my life is extremely interesting. Yeah, I do. I read a huge variety of books. No, I tend to get focused on something I really love and read that for a long time. I try to have good reasons for my important decisions. Yes. In the last month, I have found an original solution to a problem in my life. An original solution to a problem in my life. Yes. I always know what to say to make people feel good. Yes. I may not say it to others, but I consider myself to be a wise person. I'm going to say unlike me because the more I learn about life and the world and all that stuff, like the humbler I get mentally that I realize we just don't know. We just don't know. There's so much. I know so little of what is possible to know. So I always speak up and protest when I hear someone say mean things. That is like me. Trollers, beware. Thanks, Mommy Cupcakes. I also have an apple. You can't see it, but it's here. It smells delicious, and it's my first apple from my fruit tree. I love that the apple keeps coming up. This is amazing. Yeah, so when I make plans, I am certain to make them work. Yeah, very much. My friends always tell me I'm down to earth. Yes, I get you're grounded a lot. Which I feel confused by, because I feel like I'm always uncomfortable and jumping outside my comfort zone, so I feel very groundless. But I get this question, I think. I am thrilled when I can let others share the spotlight. Hell yeah. If any of you guys, speaking of that, if any of you guys ever want to come on to the stream and talk about any of this stuff, I would love to have you on. I am a life coach, and I specialize in resiliency, so if you ever want free coaching, I do that on the stream too. And you don't have to come on through video if that makes you uncomfortable. Totally get it. We can just do like a video, an audio feed, and I can even use an alias. So if that's something that is interested, either of those are interesting to you, you can just email me at info@punchlifeback.com. And we'll do that and have a great time. So I have a neighbor or someone at work or school that I really care about as a person. Yeah, of course. It's important to me to respect decisions made by my group. Unlike me. I believe that everyone should have a say. Yes. As a leader, I believe that everyone in the group should have a say in what the group does. Well, yes. Scene number 205. You guys, we are getting there. Only a little bit more to go. For me, practice is as important as performance. Yes. I always make careful choices. No, I don't. I often have a craving to experience great art such as music, drama, or paintings. No, I don't. I feel a profound sense of appreciation every day. Very much. If I feel down, I always think about what is good in my life. Very much. Yeah, so Mommy Cupcakes, what we're doing is we're going through the free survey that will tell us our top five character strengths. So I'm just reading those questions out loud, and all you would be seeing is me and the questions. It's It's not that necessary to see it. So my beliefs make my life important. Yeah, absolutely. No one would ever describe me as arrogant. I would say yes. I believe life is more of a playground than a battlefield. Yeah. Although I'm all about fighting, so I'm going to take that down a notch. I awaken with a sense of excitement about the day's possibilities. This time I'm going to go, yeah, that will go with like me. I do not want to see anyone suffer, even my worst enemy. That is like me. Most of the time. Not all the time. I really enjoy hearing about other countries and cultures. No. I mean, I don't seek it out, so I don't know. I love to read nonfiction books for fun. Yeah, that's very much like me. And I feel a little embarrassed about it, but it's true. My friends value my good judgment very much. I have a powerful urge to do something original during this next year. No. It is rare that someone can take advantage of me. Oh, no. If someone really wanted to, it's pretty easy. Others consider me to be a wise person. Yes, which makes that whole other people can't take advantage of me weird. So in other words, I'm wise, but I don't have street smarts, right? That's basically what I'm saying. I am a brave person, very much. When I get what I want, it is because I worked hard for it. Yes. Others trust me to keep their secrets, very much. I always listen to people talk about their problems. That's what I do for a living. I easily share feelings with others, very much. I gladly sacrifice my self-interest for the benefit of the group I am in. Neutral or unlike me? I'm gonna say neutral. The unlike me seemed too strong. I believe that it is worth listening to everyone's opinions. Yes. Listen. I don't have to take it. When I'm in a position of authority, I never blame others for problems. Yes, I don't, usually. I exercise on a regular basis. No, I'm working on that. I cannot imagine lying or cheating. That is very much like me. I have created something of beauty in the last year. Yeah. My pond. I made a pond. I have been richly blessed in my life. Very much like me. I expect the best. Very much like me. I have a calling in my life. Yes, this is what I'm doing right now. People are drawn to me because I'm humble? I don't think so. I am known for my good sense of humor. I don't know if that's what I'm known for. People describe me as full of zest. I'm going to go neutral on that. I don't know. I try to respond with understanding when someone treats me badly. Very much like me. I think, oh, I am clicking the finish button. I do, Mommy Cupcakes, I do like to learn things about other cultures. I just, I don't seek it out. So I thought I shouldn't give it a very much like me. And, like, I also, the stuff that came to mind that I've heard lately was about politics, and that didn't feel like I was really into hearing about that, so that all influenced that. But the thing is that, like, you don't have to be perfect in taking this assessment. It's still going to do a really, really good job at telling you what your top five strengths are, and that's all that's really needed. So, yeah, okay, so none of this is surprising to me. I've taken this test, I think, 3 times now. And my top strength is a capacity to love and be loved. So I value close relationships with others. Absolutely. This is like a cornerstone of who I am. Gratitude. Yeah, I am very, very, like, deeply grateful, and I feel grateful every day. Hope, optimism, and future-mindedness. Yes, this is all stuff that, you can see how this, like, could make me a very good coach, right? Bravery and valor. Yes, it makes me so excited and terrified at the same time, and I love hate it. Forgiveness and mercy. Yeah, these are them. Yeah, you know what's interesting is last time, the first 2 times I took this test, I had love of learning on here, and I didn't have my hope and optimism and future-mindedness. So, but I've worked a lot on, for resiliency, building my optimism and my hopefulness, because it is a really powerful way to become more resilient. So it's interesting to see that this is like telling me I successfully did that. It's pretty cool. So yeah, so here we go. I've got capacity to love and be loved, which is, it's, okay, so we'll just call that love. I call it connection, whatever. You put a word on it that means something to you when you get them. So connection, gratitude, hope, optimism, future-mindedness, bravery, and forgiveness and mercy. So whenever I come up against something that is challenging in life, right? Like I have some adversity, I have an opportunity to like pause and ask myself, how can I bring my capacity to love, my gratitude, my hope and optimism, my bravery, and my forgiveness to bear on the situation so that I can sail through it, overcome it, get better for it. And that's the resilient part. And then in life in general, I'm going to meet with a lot more well-being and flourishing the more that I just say, how can I apply these in general to my life? So like, I don't know, this is like when I feed the dogs in the morning, I have two of them. They're amazing. Like it can get like really tedious, you know, like we all have these things. So I'm just spitballing, but thinking, how can I use I could use gratitude. I could really tune into my gratitude when I'm doing a tedious chore, like feeding the dogs once again, to just be really grateful that I get to feed them, that they're here, that they're a part of my life. And that already, like that makes me feel like, yeah, that'll make that part of my life better. So that's like a little really silly, but like very true example of how we can use these things. Yeah, I would love to hear what your guys' strengths are. And like, again, like email me at info@punchlifeback.com. I would love, love, love to hear them. You can do the test on authentic happiness. Just type that into Google. It's from University of Pennsylvania. Or again, you can go to the viacharacter.org, Virtues in Action Institute. So VIA, and take their survey. I've done them both. I believe they're like basically the same thing. The VIA is going to look a little bit prettier. You can see because it just does like, and then, oh, how lovely and modern. Ooh, and it moves. The icon moves and changes shape. So anyways, yeah. Yeah, you can just like do this. Let me know what they are. I would just love to know. And let's see. So, yeah, I mean, that basically brings the character strengths part of the stream that I had in mind to a close. So, I don't know. Do you guys have any questions about this? I'd be happy to talk about it, answer it. Yeah, so while I'm just giving you guys a chance to chime in, I'm going to look at this again because I had... I have bravery. So I've got one in the virtue of courage. I have love in the virtue of humanity. I have none in the virtue of wisdom. none in justice. I have forgiveness in the virtue of temperance. And then down here in the virtue of transcendence, I have two. I have gratitude and hope. Yeah, that's funny to, I just love how I oh my God, I have none in wisdom and none in justice. And I think, oh, aren't I a bad person? And shouldn't I work very hard on increasing my virtues of wisdom and my virtues of justice until I have somehow in my top five, one from each of the six categories. So it's pretty absurd. And that wouldn't at all contribute to my well-being or to my resilience. It would literally, if I was to start, oh, cool, Solar, I'll answer that in a second. If I was to, like, just focus on my life from the virtues that I'm weaker in. Oh, so I would say that, show more. I didn't do this. So here are the virtues that I'm weaker in. Curiosity is 6. Citizenship, social intelligence, zest, love of learning, perspective, on and on and on. What am I the worst at? Modesty and humility! I saw that one coming during the test, during the survey. So yeah, if I was like, oh man, I'm not modest, I'm not creative, like that one actually hurts my heart. I don't appreciate beauty. Oh, God, I don't care about caution and prudence as much because I like my bravery. So, like, I have these judgments, right? So if I was just focused on, okay, well, I really want to be more modest because that's what a good person does. And I want to be more creative because, well, people who are creative are really valuable and I'm just not valuable if I'm not creative. If I did that and I had, like, a moment of challenge come up in my life where I was like, well, how can I use this as an opportunity to build my modesty and my creativity? Like, it's painful, right? Like, all of a sudden this, like, joyful, like, successful loop that helps us, like, flourish and be more resilient becomes this, like, efforted, heavy thing that we're trying to do. And yeah, like, I would be inching those, like, lower virtues higher, but it would just be so painful, you guys. So just be aware, like, you, when you do this, like, you are absolutely gonna, like, judge yourself. Totally normal. I think any human being would judge themselves if they take something like this. And just know that it's, like, none of us are all 24 of these things at a super high level. Like, that just doesn't exist. And that's great, because our differences make for some really awesome interactions. And if I'm weak on humility, I'm going to have a friend who's really good on it, good at it, and that's going to make me stronger when I reach out to rely on her for that or him for that. Like, you see what I'm saying? So there's no right or wrong here. It's just more helpful for you if you use this as an opportunity to use your top five strengths more and more often and really, like, build them into those kick-ass superpowers that they can be and that they probably pretty much already are in your life. Like, I for sure use my love of connecting with people to do this stream, right? Like, clearly I love having you guys all here talking with me. That's genuine. It just is who I am, and I think it's making for a more successful stream than if I was, like, afraid of you guys and didn't actually want to connect with you. Gratitude. Yeah, like, my stream, it's new. I don't have a huge audience. That's totally cool. Like, I am so grateful that you guys are here, right? And, like, you're making this, like, successful for me because I'm loving it, and I hope you're loving it too. Hope, optimism, future-mindedness, hells yeah, I'm really excited for this stream and for the potential of it, and I really think that over time, it's going to grow, the audience is going to grow, we're going to have a lot more to do, a lot more guests on, that we're going to have some live coaching that's happening. Like, I know this stuff is coming, I believe in it, I know I'm capable of bringing that to happen. Bravery, yeah, this is terrifying. Streaming is terrifying. Everybody who does it is really, really courageous in my book. So I lean on my bravery a lot. Like, I am nervous before I stream. I'm super nervous. It takes me a while to, like, really go, this is cool. This is cool. I'm happy. So, yeah. And then forgiveness and mercy. So in terms of, like, just this stream, I use this all the time when, like, afterwards I'm like, oh, Catherine, like, why did you say that? Or, like, why did you do that? And I just say, it's okay, I forgive you, basically. It's just something I do naturally. So as you can see, these five things are serving the stream really, really well. Versus if I was like, well, how can I be more humble while I cast? How can I appreciate beauty more? It's like, because I'm not naturally good at those things, it's not going to help create the community on Twitch that I really want to see happen so that this information is accessible to anybody. Like, I don't want people to have to pay for this stuff. That just makes me so sad because not everybody can afford coaching. It should be accessible to everybody. So if you want coaching and you're willing to come onto the stream, info@punchlifeback.com, let me know. So, okay. So to your question, Solar Radiant, how do these things change over time? Yeah, they do. They do. They change by the amount you use them. And there's all kinds of, if you can find a positive psychologist, like, they have interventions to help people build these strengths. So there's, like, proven methodologies to do that, or to just use your top five more and more often. And I am going to, like, go into that in the future, a little bit in more specificity, But yeah, just it just these things change by the amount you use them or don't use them. So if you have this wonderful gift of, let's say I'm looking at the list up above my head of zest, like you're just all in life and you just don't do it. You just like don't let yourself celebrate that part of yourself. It can atrophy and, you know, just like a muscle. So these are all skills. So the more you use them, the more skillful you are at them and the more success they can bring to you. The reason why you focus on your top five is because you're already like awesome at them and the success is like just there waiting for you to use it, to touch it. But yeah, absolutely. They change. You know, like I said, my hope and optimism wasn't here the last time I took this test like a year ago, but I've done a lot of work on resiliency, so it's here now. And my love of learning fell down a little bit to 10, you know, out of 24. So yeah, but my curiosity is really high, is up higher than it used to be. It's now at number 6, which curiosity and love of learning are very closely related. They're both in the virtue of wisdom. Sorry, I'm like looking up at it. So yeah, I hope that answers your question, Solar Radiant. Yeah, so if there aren't any more questions, I'm going to bring this part of the cast to a close. So one of the things that is really important to all of us is to practice, to build our awareness. And this is a skill that allows you to, here, let me switch over so you're not just staring at that anymore. Hi guys. So awareness is that skill that you can build through things like meditation that allows you to be aware of your thoughts, because in life, what you think shapes how you feel, which then shapes the actions you take. So as you build your resilience and you like learn how to like kick ass, take names and have a, and like build the life that you really, really want to live. I'm losing my train of thought because now I can see myself on the, there. Now I can only see the web camera. I don't even remember what I was saying. Well, that's just something I'll have to forgive myself for. Anyways, there's enough of a delay that you guys can't really help me. Yeah. Building your da-da-da-da-da-da-da. Yeah, no, it's totally gone. Sorry, guys. If someone in chat throws out what I was saying, I bet I could pick it up again. Awareness. So yeah. So if you don't have the awareness of what you're thinking, your life is on autopilot. So if you want to take control of your life, you got to take control of your thinking. And that starts with awareness. So what I would like to do is a real quick 5-minute guided meditation. And I promise, like, if that's like, oh my God, it's gonna be so boring. Yeah. I mean, meditation is kind of boring and it's kind of uncomfortable, but it's an opportunity to lean into the discomfort, which builds your resilience. And it's also building your ability to be aware. So it's another, like, I love distilling all of this information down to super effective, powerful tools that are very easy to apply in your life. Hence the meditation. And hence, I love the word, hence, hence the 5 character strength. So we're going to do it. I'm going to pull up the app that I love to use is Insight Timer. So I'm just going to set a 5-minute meditation timer. And it's close to the mic, so you should be able to hear it. And I'm just going to guide us through 5 minutes. It's going to be over super fast. And after that, I'm going to draw from... This is my fuck it bucket. This is what we did last week. Here we go. Fuck it bucket. Ah! And this is my bucket of really uncomfortable things to do in public. My really good friend gave this to me. This is my resiliency octopus. It's a Stretch Armstrong. So look at this. Yeah, and I love how, like, angry he is, because I feel that way sometimes when I'm like, God damn it, I have to be brave again, or I have to, like, be uncomfortable again. I really don't want to, but he does, and he goes back to his original shape, which I love. So I am going to do something that I don't want to do, which is I'm going to draw one of my actions out that we made last week, and I'm going to do this in front of you guys. So hang around through the meditation, and you will be rewarded with me probably embarrassing myself. Joy. If I have, I've already done that already a lot during the stream. So nothing new. All right. So let me check in with chat right before I... Okay, cool. So you guys are all good. I'm going to start this timer, and let's just do it. Okay, it's coming. Do you guys hear that? I hope you can hear the music. Okay, so get yourself in a comfortable position, and you can close your eyes or keep them open, whichever you prefer. If you are driving, operating heavy machinery, or doing anything that could put your life in danger, just don't meditate right now. Don't close your eyes. Don't be stupid. So yeah, but for the rest of us, you can just go ahead and take two deep breaths in through your nose and out through your mouth. Great. So now all you need to do is bring your attention, your focus, onto a part of your breathing that could be the air coming in through your nose as you inhale, and the air going out of your mouth as you exhale. It could be the rise and fall of your belly. And as you're focusing on some part of your breathing, you're gonna have thoughts that are gonna come up. It's perfectly normal. Happens to everyone. Happens to most of us all the time. And all you need to do is notice that you're thinking. And then return your focus to your breath. When a thought comes in again and you notice it and you're tempted to feel frustrated or judgy about it, just know that that's what our brain does. That's your brain working well. And this is simply an opportunity to notice and to practice noticing and bringing your attention back to your breath. That's all. There's really no right or wrong to meditation. It's just showing up. Just showing up to it. Showing up consistently over time. And when things like coughs intrude your awareness, you can notice you noticing them, and then just bring your attention back to your breath. And you might find yourself getting physically uncomfortable. Maybe you're... Oh, we're done. I think I'm going to leave it there. We can talk about physically uncomfortable next time. Yay, guys. That was 5 minutes. So really, checking with chat. Super easy stuff, right? Like meditation. Like we're taught that it can be all this like, ooh, powerful stuff. And it's very hard to do. But no, in essence, it's really, really easy. I'm going to drink some tea because... Ugh. My throat itches. It's like it knew that my voice was the only thing going on the cast, so it had to start itching. All right, so as promised, it's fuck it bucket time. And for you, those of you that missed this last week, what you do is you get a jar, whatever. I'm pretty hipster, so I have a mason jar. Deal with it. So you get something, you fill it, just look at the video, it's kind of in depth, but you just put stuff in there that makes you slightly uncomfortable, physically or emotionally, and then if you don't, the way I do it is if you haven't done something, I'm mixing them, if you haven't done something in your day that makes you physically or emotionally uncomfortable, to build your resiliency, you want to do one thing a day. That's what I say, just one thing a day. So you use the fuck it bucket. I don't technically need to do this because I am streaming, and that makes me very uncomfortable emotionally and physically sitting for a while. So yeah, but I'm going to do it because I told you guys I would. So I'm reaching in, and if this is something like I can't really do on cast, I might just draw again. So, oh, this I can't do. Wear too much. Oh, you're not going to. This says wear too much or too little. So right now that would be me taking off my shirt, which Twitch does not allow. But the idea behind this one is to make myself physically uncomfortable with temperature. So what I can do instead is here is my remote control for the heater / thermos right above me. So I'm going to make it horribly hot in here. I'm so sorry to my dog who's behind me hiding. I'm going to bring it up as high as it goes. It's at 86 degrees. It's like right above my head. So there you go, guys. And I'll do that for the rest of the cast. Oh, God. I'm going to like have sweat pits. And you guys are all going to laugh at me. So that's the fuck it bucket. All right. Sweet. Yeah. So I will be practicing my resilience as soon as it gets really hot in here. And here's the key. I don't try to fix it. I just stay in the discomfort. And what's cool is research shows that when you build your tolerance to physically uncomfortable things, you're actually building your tolerance to emotionally uncomfortable things. And the emotional stuff is what I struggle with. That's the stuff that causes me the most fear. So it's an awesome, again, like a super simple tool that's relatively easy to do that will help you build your resiliency over time. So that is the fuck it bucket. We are going to go to, first of all, I feel like we can use some music. Oh, my headset is not on anymore. Hold on. I want to hear what you guys are hearing. There we go. Yeah, so we're going to check out Habitica. So I do this. I do this every stream because I love Habitica. This is where you can gamify your life. And we have a party on Habitica, and if you would like to join us, there are still spots available. Sorry, this is just their promo stuff. It's free to do, habitica.com. Here we are, here's the party up top. We've got Mythmeg, Tiki, Yeti, and Boots Boreal, and of course me, Punch Life Back. And this is what you do. You create habits, dailies, to-dos, and you do them every day. And they're like, it's just your to-do list, but in a really powerful way. So look at this, guys. I definitely got uncomfortable because I streamed and I just gained a whole bunch of stuff. A hatching potion. I meditated before the stream and I meditated on the stream. Total of 10 minutes. I have not done that yet. Not done that yet. I have done this. Still need to exercise. And then, okay, so last week when we did the fuck it bucket, I moved my task for it to here, called Get Uncomfortable. Look for in life and take from the fuck it bucket if nothing arises. I realized during my week as I was doing this that I was getting uncomfortable more than once a day, and I felt like I wanted to reward myself for it. So I added that into a habit. So because I Twitch streamed, which made me check off this Get Uncomfortable, and I reached through my Resiliency Octopus Fuck It Bucket, I am gonna click Discomfort Overflow. And when I click it, you can see that my experience just rose. And yeah, I'm not perfect, guys, right? Like, my health is dinged because I didn't do some of the stuff I said I would do. But if you look at this, I've had an 8-streak counter for my daily Get Uncomfortable. So I'm definitely doing that. And that feels really, really awesome. I only have a 5-day streak with meditation, so I'm working on that. Again, like, I'm being super open here. You guys can see where I'm succeeding, where I'm failing, because it's all good. It is all good. So yeah, so I'm gonna go, I save going into my inventory until I stream. So I have no idea. This is all the stuff that I've collected this week. I'm really starting to like rake in the goodies. So let's see, we got a dragon! I can hatch, so I won a dragon by doing stuff. Dragon, a flying pig, a bear cub. We have a lion and we already have a wolf, so we're not gonna do those. I really wanna hatch my dragon and my flying pig. So then my potions to hatch it. Oh, a white dragon. Oh my god, you guys, it's getting so hot in here. It's so hot. Okay, here's my discomfort. I'm just gonna sit in the heat and melt. And melt. Okay, so white dragon, desert dragon, cotton candy blue, shade. Let me know what you guys want in chat and I'll do it. Cotton candy pink, base. I think the base just means it comes out whatever the like OG color is. Yeah. And then I got my food to feed my, oh, I got a special. No, that's for subscribers only. So I do have another quest. It's the Bazai list. That's good. So while I'm waiting to hear from you guys what animal you want me to hatch and what color you want me to do, oh my god, I just noticed that Mythmeg, I think that might be a baby dragon. I'm really jealous. I see that, like, Yeti is riding a dragon, which makes my purple lion look a lot less cool. So anyways, while I'm waiting for that, I'm gonna go into party and check out what my party's doing. Cool, so we're on a quest, and I'm really trying to keep the quest going, so this means that the whole party agrees to do a quest. We're fighting a boss. We're saving Habitica, the people of Habitica, and we're doing it together. So when we do the things we say we're gonna do, we do damage to the boss. When we don't, the boss damages the entire party. So when I don't meditate like I say I will, I end up screwing everybody over, and that accountability is really sweet. Plus we get to like chat with each other and see like the damage that each other, like that we're all doing and that kind of stuff. So cool. I don't need to do anything with my member list. Just if you guys want to join us, it's free. We've got spaces for 30 more people, and we can all, we just have a lot of fun during the week doing it between casts. And yeah, just email me info@punchlifeback.com and you're all good. So let's see, I'm gonna go in here and I'm gonna do a white dragon because that's what I want, and I didn't see anything in chat. Oh, he's so cute with really creepy red laser eyes. Yeah. Okay, and then I'm gonna do an OG pig because, I mean, who doesn't like a pink pig? And, oh, a bear cub. I'm gonna do a desert bear. Oh, cute. Cute. All right, so I'm gonna go to my stable and I'm gonna feed these guys. Wow, so there's my standard. What? I have a fox. There's my dragon. All right, I'm guessing that a dragon likes rotten meat. No, it doesn't seem to enjoy it. No, but I want my dragon to be mature so I can ride him. Do you like strawberries? Nope, doesn't like strawberries. No, can't, come on, it's taking all my resources. All right, I'm guessing he likes meat and I don't have any. So, yeah. All right. Oh, I like my shade. Shade wolf. Yeah, see, I'm just wasting, but I like wasting. I guess I like wasting. All right, we used it all. So yeah, carnivores like carnivore things, I would assume. Boom, boom. All right, so let's see if I can buy anything. What are these? Poinsettia. Oh, that's right. So guys, I'm now level 12, but at level 9 in Habitica, you get to choose your character class. So there's healer, mage, rogue, and warrior. I chose rogue. And the reason why I did it is because rogues get more drops. And I wanted that so that I could show you more of the stuff that Habitica gives you, basically. So Mythmag is a warrior. You all start as a warrior. I'm not sure if she's chosen to be a warrior or not. But like once you're at, so you choose your class and then at higher levels you get special attacks, which are pretty fun. Tiki's our healer. She's level 91. She's awesome. We got another rogue is Yeti, 45, definitely kicking my ass. And oh, we have a lot of rogues. And then Boots Burial, level 54 rogue. Very cool. So what was I doing? Oh yeah, so the announcement that I like erased when I got on was about this poinsettia thing. It is the holiday rogue thing that I can buy, and I have 222.95 coins that I've earned. I'm doing good on health, so I don't have to buy a potion. I'm gonna go for it. I'm gonna be an adorable rogue. So there's a bouquet, armor, helmet, and a... Oh, I can hold two bouquets. That's hilarious. All right, let's go for the helmet first. Yes. Ah, I put it on my head. I look like a Habitica version of Poison Ivy. Oh, I don't have enough for them. Okay, well, next week, I'll be able to buy those. All right, where are we at? Yeah, so I'm thinking I'm like, yeah, let me see, let's switch back over. Hey guys. So I'm thinking I'm gonna wrap the cast up unless you guys want me to play like Child of Light for 20 minutes, which I love to do because it's beautiful, makes me feel good, and helps me flourish. Yeah, that's my very like loose tie-in to justify playing a game that I love on this cast. Don't think you guys will mind. Let me know if you want me to do that for like the 20 minutes that I have left before I have to go. Otherwise, I'll just start wrapping up. I am going to be up north, like Northern California. I live in Southern California next week during this. So I try to cast every Thursday at 1 p.m. Pacific time. I won't be here with my setup, so I will have my laptop. And this week I'm going to try to make that work because I have a really good friend of mine that's gonna come on, hopefully, and she's an intuitive guide and a medium. And I really wanted her to come on because I work a lot with intuition as a coach, and I see how it can really help us in our resiliency. And my approach to it tends to be kind of like scientific. Like I want to understand how it's working in the brain. Whereas my really good friend has much more of a like a spiritual approach to it. And I just thought that the conversation between the two of us could be really, really cool and really fun. And she's awesome. She's full of like the most amazing energy. She's like a very contagious person. Like she's just that much fun. So I think she'll be just really awesome to have on the stream. So hopefully I can make that happen. If it doesn't happen next week, it will happen. We'll just have to work it out with her schedule, which is a little tricky. What else? Definitely follow Punch Life Back on Twitch if you like this. I'm here every Thursday. You can also just like connect with me through email at info@punchlifeback.com. Again, I would love if like you are an expert in something related to this stuff, I would love to have you on that we could just talk shop and have a good time doing that. If you want to explore a coaching session and see what it's like to be coached on your resiliency and whatever it is that you want to improve in your life, I believe that coaching should be available to everybody. So this stream is part of my mission to make that happen. So I always hold space on the stream for some live coaching sessions. So you can email me info@punchlifeback.com to volunteer and just have a conversation with me about what that would be like. I will make it as safe and comfortable as I possibly can, but I understand that it takes courage to show up here and be in front of people, whether that's your face through a video feed or that's just your voice through an audio-only feed. I get it. It takes courage. I can help you a little bit by, if you really want, I can also call you by an alias. You don't have to use your, you know, your tag or anything like that that you don't want to have out there. That's part of my mission. I care about it a lot. So reach out to me, volunteer. It is all good. Okay, we've got a taker on, we've got Solar wanting Shadow Light. So let me get it up and running and then I'll just jump right on over to it and we'll play it. I'm so happy you said that because I really wanted to do it. All right. Oh, you're going to start hearing it here probably. And it'll be all kinds of confusing because I've got way too much stuff playing right now. I only have one monitor, so streaming is a little challenging. Okay, so there we go with that. I think Child of Light is up and running. Let's see. So guys, I don't have dual monitors, right? So all I see right now is the game. So I need Solar Radiant. If you can just confirm in chat or anybody that it's all working, you can see the game, you can hear the game, you can see and hear me, I would really appreciate it. We don't need downloadable content. So we are, oh my god, it is so hot in here. Wow, thank you, Fuck It Bucket, for that gift today. Much like